Welcome to my short presentation at the Inclusive Science Symposium. My name is Christian Humm. I'm a researcher at the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology in the Department of Science Communication. Today, I will talk about a science poetry slam with and for young Muslims in Germany that we did. What's the initial situation? The status quo. Studies show that the audiences for science communication in the West are often predominantly male, older, highly educated, socioeconomically better off, and they have a white ethnic background. To gain a better insight into the reasons behind this and the needed changes, my colleagues and I did a research and practice project in the last years. This project was called Science for All. In the project, we developed, implemented and evaluated three science communication formats together with three underrepresented audiences in Germany. One of them were young Muslims with a migration background, about whom I want to speak here. In their case, we cooperated with two associations, iSLAM and Heroes, as access points to the community. We started by identifying needs and barriers together with them. They had on the one hand a high interest in science and technology, especially in the societal implications, and they liked to discuss about it in the focus groups we did. On the other hand, they did not participate in science communication events. For example, they did not go to museums, public lectures or science slams. They experienced discrimination because of their ethnicity and religion during their education at school or university. For example, they were recommended by teachers not to go to university after finishing school, but to learn a trade, while pupils without a migration background did not get such a recommendation. As a result, they were not seen and did not see themselves as a science person, partly because they did not know of any scientists with the same background as them, with whom they might identify themselves. Thus, science for them was white and Eurocentric. Based on this assessment, we developed a science poetry slam together with them. You can see a photo taken at the slam on the slide. Slam, because poetry slams, not science slams, are a known format for the groups we collaborated with. The slam did take place at a youth club in Berlin from 8 to 10 p.m. Four poets and three scientists presented in alternation. They had a migration background or identified themselves as Muslims. One moderator from the community introduced them and interviewed them afterwards. For example, the scientists were asked about their way into science. The slam had two goals. First, to show the audience scientific role models they can identify with. And at the same time, we wanted that the audience had an entertaining evening in a welcoming and familiar atmosphere. From the four poets that appeared on stage, two identified as female and two as male. They covered the topics of education, belonging, international and national politics in their slams. The scientists were early career researchers, all three were female. They covered medicine, mathematics and physics in their slams. The socio-demographic results from the evaluation showed that around 70 people attended. 60 of them identified themselves as female. The average age was 21 years, the youngest was 11 years and the oldest 40. 24% had a university degree and 40% a high school diploma. 56% had a migration background and 48% identified themselves as Muslims. We also gained some more qualitative data. The audience was very satisfied with the event. 80% stated that it was very good. 64% said they learned something new, and the majority identified themselves with the scientists on stage. For example, they stated that finally somebody like them was present on the stage and showed them that they could be a science person too. The combination of something familiar, poetry slam, and something new, science slam, was appreciated. There were also some points that were not so good. It was difficult to find scientists. The time slot was too late for the younger persons in the audience, and it was only a one-time activity with no follow-up. What are our five main learnings from the Science Poetry Slam and the project in general? First, collaboration with the community and listening to them is key. Otherwise, there will be no access and your content won't matter. Second, we have to create a space for role models and people with whom the audience can identify. Third, activities need to be sustainable. One-time events and limited pilot formats like this won't have any real impact. Fourth, the community has to benefit from activities. Their time and engagement is not free, so they have to get a material return for it. And fifth, you need to know your limits. Science communication, no matter how good, won't solve any structural problem, like discrimination in the school system. In order to make the project's results and learnings accessible, especially to practitioners, we created a hidden object picture of which you can see a detail on the slide. On the picture, exclusion factors, that are factors responsible for excluding people from science communication, are visually illustrated and accompanied by short explanations. You can download it for free via the link or order a free copy by mailing me. And that's it. Thank you for your attention.